Hi friends, I want to share a good news. Tech giant Google announces India Digitization Fund invests a $10 billion, that is 75,000 crores over 5 to 7 years. Google and Alphabet CEO Sundar Pichai on July 13 announced a $10 billion, that is 75,000 crores, Google for India Digitization Fund that will assist in accelerating Prime Minister Narendra Modi's vision to digitize the Indian economy. Pichai made the announcement right after his virtual meeting with Prime Minister Modi at the Google for India 2020 event. About Google. Google, an MNC with a net worth of $133 billion. Google apps are the most user-friendly. Google already supports current COVID pandemic situation to carry on schooling and learning with ease with apps like Google Meet and Google Classroom, to name a few. Google launched 66 plus useful apps. These are the apps. Digital India, Power to Empower. Taking the power of digital to the next level, empowering people, enriching lives. Digital India, launched on 1st July 2015 by Indian Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi with the motto Power to Empower. Digital India is a campaign launched by the Government of India in order to digitally empower the country. The government has launched 35 plus useful government apps. Sri Narendra Modi bravely took many steps to bring up India. All the world nations are looking up at Sri Narendra Modi as a good leader and mentor. I dream of a digital India where access to information knows no barriers, says Sri Narendra Modi. Human capital and tech giants are joining hands. How Google will invest in India? Google will invest this amount through a mix of equity investment, partnership, and operational infrastructure and ecosystem investment. First, in enabling affordable access and information for every Indian in their own language, whether it's Hindi, Tamil, Punjabi, or any other language. Second, for building a new product and services that are deeply relevant to India's unique need. Third, for empowering businesses as they continue or embark on their digital transformation. Fourth, to leverage technology and AI, artificial intelligence, for social good in areas like health, education, and agriculture. Google also announced a partnership with Central Board of Secondary Education, that is CBSE, to offer digital learning modules across schools in India. The company will partner with 1 million teachers across 22,000 CBSE schools across the country by December end. The learning content will be offered through a blended module. This means that there will be a mix of online learning with traditional classroom lessons. This is a significant move as the announcement comes despite the COVID-19-led disruptions and reflect confidence in the country's growth story. It also testifies India's attractiveness as an investment destination. Why Google is investing in India? The investment will not only boost India's digital growth, but will further promote Google's own product, payment service like Google Pay and Google Search, and futuristic technologies like artificial intelligence, where Google is making headway. Ravi Shankar Prasad, IT Minister, hopes Google will help in digitizing more villages. The minister also encouraged Indian entrepreneurs to develop digital products. India's app economy is growing very powerfully, he said, but added that India should not just download apps, as it is also important to upload apps made in India. These are the opportunities waiting to be tapped, the minister said. Interesting facts and figures. As of 31st December 2018, India had a population of 130 crore people. 123 crore got Aadhaar digital biometric identity card. 121 crore have mobile phones. 44 crores have smartphones. 56 crore people are internet users. There is a 51% growth in e-commerce. What is our role? While we appreciate and express a positive gesture of welcoming Google investment in India, it is our duty to sow seeds in young minds that they have to be trained to take up entrepreneurship and bring up India. Parents should educate their children to take up a business than just to pursue education and go for a job. Young minds, schoolgoers, college students and other aspirants should be motivated to take up business venture instead of looking for job alone. Create an employer-driven society and enable self-employment, which will eventually reduce concentration of economic power and ensure equitable growth in all the industries. Growth focus should be on small businesses. More small businesses are becoming part of the formal economy and shifting from unorganized sector of financial market to organized sector. This should be encouraged, which makes our Indian financial market more transparent, transactional and transformational. As rightly said by our IT Minister Ravi Shankar Prasad, India should not just download apps, it is also important to upload apps made in India. The minister also encouraged Indian entrepreneurs to develop digital products. Cheer up India! If you enjoyed this video, like, share and subscribe. Thank you.